For hundreds of years, early men hunted whales because their meat and blubber were able to fulfill their basic survival needs. Every part of the mammal was either eaten or used to light lamps, make tools, and sleds. Beyond its usefulness to the human race in our infancy, whales had something else which most people would kill to have today. And by that, I mean their ability to live far longer than any human. A male bowhead whale, which so happens to be the second largest mammal on Earth, is capable of living at least 150 years, and perhaps as long as 200, and they live their entire lives roaming the seas without needing to see the doctor from time to time. I have stated all of this to point out that aging is not an inevitable fact of life. As we can see, many animals have already found ways to delay death and are living proof that we humans could possibly replicate their success at life extension. Now before we continue, I'd like you all to know I make new videos on Sundays every week, so please like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel for more great content. The first possible path which could allow us to extend our lives substantially is the partial or complete replacement of our old biological body parts with new biological or cybernetic ones. Even for those of us who live extraordinarily long lives, death inevitably comes, usually because of multiple organ failures within the body. So imagine if we could replace these organs with lab-grown clones before they became completely useless. Human cloning is completely achievable with today's technology, and we have even seen breakthroughs in organ farming techniques, which basically allow scientists to grow fully functional human organs from nothing more than stem cells in a lab. Millions of people around the world die from organ failure each day, but with organ farming and human cloning, the raw materials needed to keep our bodies going could easily be harvested, further prolonging our lives. Cybernetic implants and prosthetics could also be utilized to provide us with more durable organs and limbs, which would allow us to live much longer. Although the question remains, if we keep replacing body parts with inorganic materials, at which point do you stop being you? Another technique which could allow us achieve life extension is by use of nanotechnology. These microscopic machines could destroy cancer cells, filter harmful substances from our blood, or be used to repair everything from organs to even our DNA once introduced into our bodies. Although that sounds completely fictional, nanotech has already been applied in several test cases around the world. Scientists from MIT and Hong Kong have managed to repair the optic nerves in blind hamsters by building a custom synthetic molecule that, when injected, arranges itself into a nanofiber to repair the nerve. Given its sheer potential, I'm more than certain that nanotechnology will be used to extend our lives, at least partially, while utilizing other methods as well. Cryogenesis is another means of achieving life extension. Theoretically, it could be done in one of two ways. First, a person could be suspended in a low metabolic state where vital functions are kept to a bare minimum by cooling the body while not actually killing the person. The second method would involve replacing the water in our cells with an anti-freezing agent, which would prevent the cells from bursting as the body is cooled to temperatures below minus 200 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, some of you may not agree that this is a means of life extension, but it most certainly is, considering it would preserve your physical form for decades without cellular degradation, allowing you to come back to life maybe in 50 years or more in the future without aging a single day. Technologies like CRISPR could be used in the future to isolate genes in our DNA which are responsible for aging and nullifying their effects permanently, or at least making them less potent. The chances of us achieving partial immortality from such a process is quite high when you consider the breakdown in our cells that causes us to get frail and wrinkly is caused by a specific set of defects that our science is only beginning to understand. Genetic modification could also be done on human embryos, giving them specific mutations which would prevent aging at later stages of life. A large array of genetic modifications have already been found to increase the lifespan of several organisms. The longest extension of life caused by a single gene modification led to a lifespan increase of roughly 150% in mice. We will also see an emergence of anti-aging serums, which could even reverse the effects of aging by causing cellular rejuvenation. A group of scientists from the University of Lund were able to effectively spark cellular rejuvenation in old mice by use of stem cells, which caused the old mice to produce blood cells functionally similar to those seen in younger mice. For those wondering when I'll mention the digitization of human consciousness, I'm sorry guys, but it's simply not coming. Fact is, I simply don't believe it's a true means of extending human life. Now, I'm of the opinion that true immortality is rather impossible. Everything that has a beginning will most certainly have an end. Even our universe in its vastness does not escape this fact. So basically, none of the methods I've mentioned so far will allow us to live till the end of time. However, if they provide us with more time to spend with the ones we love, to make our greatest dreams become a reality, or perhaps give us the time we need to build a better future for humanity, then living a bit longer would certainly be worth it.